Hello everyone, myself Ashish Desai, Assistant Professor, Mechanical Department. Today we are going to discuss here unit number 3, Fluid Kinematics. So first of all, we look at the learning objective. So first learning objective is to know about fluid kinematics. Second learning objective is to understand about method of fluid flow. So after this session, some learning outcome is there. So first learning outcome is the student will able to explain about fluid kinematics. Second learning outcome is the student will able to explain about Lagrange method versus Euler's method. So first of all, we'll look at the fluid kinematics. So it is a branch of fluid mechanics which deals with the response of fluids in a motion without considering the forces. So this is nothing but a fluid kinematics. So it is often referred as a geometry of motion. So generally it is focuses on velocity and acceleration of fluid flow, and it is generally the function of space and time. So this is regarding the fluid kinematics. So always remember that the fluid is in motion and pressure forces are not considered there. That is nothing but fluid kinematics. Now we define the fluid flow. So there are two approaches there. So first approach is the Lagrange approach and second is a Euler's approach. So first of all, we look at the main difference between Lagrange method and Euler's method. So in the Lagrange method, the single fluid particle is chosen and followed during its motion and find out its properties. So that is called as Lagrange method. So here the figure shows that we have to trace out the fluid particle and we can define all these properties. So this is called as a Lagrange method. But next properties of method is Euler's method. So in this method, a point or section is chosen for flow field. Suppose we have to considering this this channel is there. So this is a white part we are mentioning here. This is your fixed volume and your particle moves from this end to this end. So we have to observe over here and we have to study the properties. So this is called as Euler's method. So normally the Euler's method is used because it is useful to all the methods and it is not tedious and complicated. So it is easier method. That's why it is we can use Euler's method maximum times. Now we move for the difference between Lagrange method versus Euler's method. So in Lagrange method, the follows a fluid particle. Suppose the example is given here. The red car is there, which is follow the blue car. So you have to follow means you have to check out the property of the blue car by using this red car. So this is the Lagrange fluid motion. Then about Euler's method. So it is observed from stationary point. So here the example is there. We have to consider the fixed volume and here observe via the fluid particles across this specific volume. So this is called as Euler's fluid motion. So this is simple method, because you do not follow all these particles over here, only you have to follow the fixed volume. So this is why the Euler's method is mostly used in a fluid flow motions. Okay, so this is the observation. So here also mentioned that the motion of single particle is there and here motion of the fluid particle across the specific volume or time. So this is the difference between Lagrange method and Euler's method. Now we move for the Lagrange method in detail. So as you know that we have to observe the fluid particle, single fluid particle, and we have to study the properties of this fluid. So here we have to observe the velocity and acceleration. So as you know that in a Cartesian coordinate system, we are defining the that fluid particle. So as you know that the fluid kinematics is specifically depends on space and time. So while defining the property for velocity or acceleration, so you have to mention the space and time. So here the x, y, z is the coordinate system and a, b, c is the location. So you have to tracing the locations. So we are tracing 3 points. That's why I can write a, b, c is a that tracing points and t is a time. So x is nothing but your coordinate system. So the fluid is in motion. So we are tracing the a, b, c and t. So t is nothing but time. So a, b, c tells about space. Similarly for y, you are tracing the three points A, B, C, and time is a phenomenon. So this is why the y is function of space and time. So here also z. So z is a function of A, B, C, and t. That means A, B, C is the space and t stands for time. So this is regarding the defining the path. Now we define for the velocity components. So as you know that u is nothing but dx by dt. Dx by dt means when you define the velocity, so u is equal to, so for x direction we are considering x direction, so u is equal to dx by dt. So we are, if you take a differentiate with respect to x, then we get the value of u, that is u is equal to dx by dt. Similarly for v, so while defining the y component velocity, so we differentiate with time for y, so dy by dt is equal to v. So this is regarding the velocity component. So same as for z direction, so in a z direction we are defining the space and time, and if you take the differential with time, dou z by dou t, or that dz by dt, it is called as a w, because in a z direction we consider the w. So here again I repeat, thus u is always, remember that in a x direction, v is always, remember that in y direction, and w is in a z directions. So this is regarding the velocity components. And if you find out for resultant velocity, we can take v capital is equal to under root of this velocity, that is u square plus v square plus w square. So this will give the resultant velocity for Lagrange method. Similarly for we're defining for acceleration, because acceleration here, so only we are defined for acceleration, we can take a differentiate with this velocity once again. So that's why I can write ax is equal to dou 2 x by dt square. And for y direction acceleration, we take a differentiate for two times, that's why dou 2 y by dt square. And for z direction, that's why we can differentiate with a dou 2 z by dou t square. So this is called as acceleration component. And for acceleration is nothing but a is equal to square root of a square plus a y square plus a z square. So in that Lagrange method, when you concentrate on a one point, so we are defining this velocity and accelerations, so that will give these values. So this value, if you take number of points, so suppose you are taking 30-40 points, so we are defining 30-40 points and that velocity and that acceleration, so that method will becomes tedious. So that's why we go for the next method, that is Euler's method. So this is mostly used because your concentrated area is only a specific volume, or you can say constant volume. So that's why the Euler's method is simple one, and you have to observe easily the velocity and acceleration. So for the purpose, we have to fix the session in a space. So while defining the velocity in x, y, z direction, so this x, y, z is a Cartesian coordinate system and t is a time. So while defining the velocity u, we can take x, y, z and t, right? And for v component, so v component is in a velocity, that function to x, y, z, that is about space and this is time. Similarly for w, so when you take the function x, y, z, t, that is x, y, z is space and t is for time. So this is regarding the velocity components. So while defining the velocity components, u is equal to dx by dt, v is equal to dy by dt, and w is equal to dz by dt. That means when you're defining the u, that is velocity in an x direction, so we can take dx by dt, right? And for v, so while defining the velocity v, we can take differentiation with respect to y with respect to t, that means dy by dt. And while defining the velocity w, we can take the differentiation with respect to z, that means dz by dt. So this is gives the idea regarding the velocity, that is u, v, w. Okay. Now we go for the velocity vector. So in a Euler's method, that we can mention like this, v is equal to ui plus vj plus wk. So ij is the velocity vectors and u, v, w is the velocity components. U is nothing but dx by dt, right? V is equal to dy by dt, w is equal to dz by dt. So while defining the u in a resultant velocity, so capital V is equal to u square. So you can take u here, bracket square, v can take v square, w can take as it is and square, and we can take square root. So we'll get the resultant velocity. So while defining the velocity vector, that is v is equal to ui plus vj plus wk. Now similarly for acceleration vector, so a is equal to axi plus ayj plus azk. So ax, ay, az, the acceleration in a x, y, z direction respectively, right? And while defining the that resultant acceleration, we can take small a is equal to ax square plus ay square plus az square. So this is called as the resultant acceleration. So normally we are defining the Euler's method, we have to concentrate on that specific volume, or can say specific stations. So we are defining the space and time, we can take this consideration for velocity and acceleration. Now we discuss about the velocity and acceleration. So mostly we know that the useful method for fluid flow is the Euler's method. So while defining the velocity in Euler's method, so as we know that capital V is the resultant velocity, let u, v, w is the velocity components, x, y, z is the Cartesian coordinates, or can say that particular directions, x, y, z directions, and t is the time. So that means the velocity components, u is the velocity component, is the function of space coordinate, that is x, y, z is the space coordinates, and time, that is time. So this mathematical format you can write for u, v, w. And for velocity, that is the resultant velocity, we can calculate from this equation ui v plus vj plus wk. So if you know that this relation, u can take u square, v square, w square, and under that is square root, you can take it. So we will get the value of resultant velocity. So this is approach for Euler's fluid flow method. Now we may move for the acceleration. So while defining the acceleration, so axy, ay, and az is called as total acceleration in xyz direction respectively. And while defining the chain rule, ax is equal to ui dt. So I already discussed this. So acceleration means the rate of change of velocity with respect to time. So here x is a x is a direction. So along x direction, we can take u. That's why du by dt. Now we take the chain rule. So that's why you can differentiate it with four times. So du by dt. So that means what? Suppose this is one and we have to differentiation with respect to partial derivative. So partial derivative means, suppose this is one, we can take 0.25, 0.25, 0.25, 0.25. That means addition will be one. So this is called as partial differentiation. So there is no change in the meaning, right? There is no change in meaning. Only we write this du by dt in a four times, but with respect to partial derivative, okay? That much change is there. Otherwise, the meaning is same. Now, we take du by dt, we can write like this. Dou u by dt, we can write dou u by dou t on that side, and dou x by dou x. So that will cancel out, and again, we can remain only du by dt. So dx and dx will cancel out, right? That means this is partial derivative. Only we have to add this purpose, we can write that value, that is dx by dou x. So that by plus. Similarly, for we can write for y. So this is y, dou u by dou t, we can take in a diagonal manner, and dou y, dou y in a that diagonal manner, right? So only that cancelled out, only remains this value. Similarly for this z value. So dou u by dou z into dou z by dou t. So this is partial derivative, we can take directly, plus this term as it is, we can take as it is. Now we can, while defining the kinematics, as we know that this xyz coordinate system and this is your time, that means this is the respect to space and this is respect to time. So that's why we know that dx by dt is u, dy by dt means v, dz by dt means w. So only we can put the value here. Instead of dx by dt, you can write u. That means equation becomes u dou u by dou x, u dou u dou by dou x, dy by dt is nothing but v. So here v, and this dou u by dou y plus dou z by dou t is, you can write w, and dou u by dou z plus dou u by dou t. So this is regarding the x direction. Similarly, we can write for y direction. Only that much change is there. Only u we can replace by v. Otherwise, same term is there. That's why dou e only change u. U changes there, v. U changes there, v. U changes v. Otherwise, same. Similarly, for z direction, only changes w. So when respect to w, we can change this w only here. Here, otherwise it is same. Okay. So this is regarding the ax, ay, az. So while defining the acceleration, this is simple method. Again, I repeat, this is by chain rule. So this is called as chain rule. So while defining the chain rule, as you know that ax is equal to du by dt. So this is a full derivative. As you consider, we can take partial derivative. So that's why I can take four parts. So for that purpose, I can take in a partial format like this: dou u by dou t plus dou u by dou t plus dou u by dou t plus dou u by dou t. So that's 0.25, 0.25, and 0.25, 0.25. That becomes 1. So that is the change. Okay. Now we can change with the chain rule. So dou x by dou e, dou x we can write in a diagonal manner. Otherwise, this is the same because dou u by dou t is same. So this is the change we are take here. Similarly, we can change dou by dou y. Diagonally only change. For this value, plus for this value, we can change dou z by dou z, and plus we can take as it is because this value is for space and this value is for time. Now we can solve it. As you know that dx by dt means u, right? Dx by dt means u. Dy by dt means v. Dz by dt means w. So we can put this value and we can calculate the ax like this. Ax means dou by dou t, and only change instead of dx by dt is u, dy by dt means v, dz by dt means w, and this value is same. So this is called as ax. So similarly for ay, so only changes for u, instead of you can write v, otherwise same. For z purpose, only changes w, otherwise same. So that means az is equal to dou w by dou t, u as it is. The dou instead of v can write w, right? So here also plus v dou w, w dou y plus w as it is dou w by dou z plus dou u by dou t. So this is the relation for acceleration. Now we go for the velocity formula. So as we discussed already, this is the formula for resultant calculation of resultant velocity. This is the formula for the acceleration in x direction, y direction, and z direction. So already we discussed in previous slides. So now we move for the problem. So in velocity and acceleration, we have to find out in a problem. So this acceleration we can compute for the acceleration vector, that axi plus ayj plus azk. So that we use the ax square plus ay square plus az square. So this is the value. So if you know the ax value, ay value, az value, we can take that square values and take the square root. That will use the acceleration. So as we know that the ax, so ax is how to calculate. So as we'll if you know the u, we can take the derivative with respect to time. If you know the v, then we can take time, then you get the ay. If you get the know the w, you can take a differential with respect to t. That's what gives dwdt. Then we get direct the value of z. But sometimes it is unknown, so that's why you calculate this value first. Partial derivative for with respect to x, partial with y, partial with z, partial with t, and put the value. Then will the ax. Similarly for ay, we can take the derivative with partial derivative with v. Then we get the value of this full things, and then we get the value of ay. Similarly for az. So like this, we can calculate the ax, ay, az, and then we go for the finalization of acceleration. So now we move for the velocity and acceleration. So this is the example. A fluid flow field is given by capital V, that is the resultant velocity is there. That's why, or you can say velocity vector is there. So velocity vector V is equal to x square y I plus y square z j minus in bracket 2xyz plus yz square into bracket k. Calculate the velocity and acceleration at the point 2, 1, 3. So in this example, we are giving that velocity vector and find out the velocity and acceleration. The point is 2, 1, 3. 2, 1, 3 means the x is equal to 2, y is equal to 1, and z is equal to 3. So before we start this solution, as you know that for x direction, velocity is u. For y direction, velocity is v. For w, velocity is, for that is velocity w is there, and component is the z direction. So in z direction, you can define as a velocity w. So this is the basic thing. As you know that velocity and acceleration formula. So first of all, we write the velocity vector. So this is same equation as we know that this same equation we can write for here. And now if you compare this value with respect to this velocity vector, this is your standard form. So how to find out this u value? We compare these two equations. So we get the value for u. After comparing, u is equal to x square y, right? For comparing, v is equal to y square z. And for w, so w is equal to minus 2xyz plus yz square, like this. So only you have to change the sign convention, minus and inside also minus. So this is the value of w. So as you know that the velocity point is 2, 1, 3, that means x is equal to 2, y is equal to 1, z is equal to 3. So this is the value regarding the point. Now as we know that the value for this is velocity vector, so we can take v, capital V, and put the value of x, y and z. So here we can take value putting directly. So x square means that 2 square into 1 plus 1 square plus into 3, because z value is 3. Then x is 2, y is 1, sorry, y is 1, right, z is 3. So 2, 2, 3 plus y is 1, so 1 plus z square, that is 3 square into k. So after that, putting this value, the equation becomes like this: 4i plus 3j minus 21k. So this is the form, this is the form for the velocity vector. Now we compute for velocity. So that's why, as we know that resultant velocity is equal to v is equal to square root of u square plus v square plus w square. So first of all, we put the value of u here, that is u is nothing but 4. For v is, we can take as a 3. W we can take a minus 20. So we can take square of this. So 4 square is equal to become 16. 3 square is become 9. 20 square is nearly but 4, 4, 1. And we can take square root of this. Then we get the value of resultant velocity. So that is the 21.587. So here the unit is not mentioned here. So that's why I mention here the units. Okay. So this is the change for this. Now we move for acceleration. So we know that acceleration at point is 2, 1, 3. That means x is equal to 2, y is equal to 1, z is equal to 3. So already we discussed this formula. So in x direction, you can write ax is equal to u plus u into dou u by dou x plus v dou u by dou y plus w dou u by dou z plus dou u by dou t. Similarly for ay and az. Only if you know this form, that ax form, only you change the u instead of v, like this. Only you change w, only you change w. Otherwise all the formula will be same. Okay. So define ax, y, az. Write this formula, and according to, we can work out first. So if you know that value of u, so already we discussed this point, you know that u value is how much? X square y. V value is y square z, and w value is minus 2xyz minus y square square. So first of all, we take u value like this. Now we compute for dou u by dou x. Please concentrate over here. Dou u by dou x dou u by dou y, dou u by dou z, dou u by dou t. So first of all, we go for dou u by dou x, right? Dou u by dou x. First of all, we find this value. Dou u by dou x means with respect to x. That's why 2xy. Okay. So these two go that side, and 2 minus 1. That's why 1. That's why 2xy. Now we define for dou u by dou y. Dou u by dou y. So what will happen? Only x square, right? Then we go for dou u by dou z. Dou u by dou z. So z is absent. So while differentiation becomes 0, this value is become 0 because z is absent in the form of z, value of u. So dou u by dou z is 0. Dou u by dou t. So here also t is absent. That's why we can take 0 value. That is why dou u by dou t is 0. So this is regarding the u value. Now we concentrate for dou u by dou x, dou u by dou y, dou u by dou z, dou u by dou t. So first of all, we concentrate for the equation. So as you know that v is equal to y square z. So first of all, we calculate dou u by dou x, dou u by dou x. So here x is absent, that's why that value becomes 0. Next value is dou v by dou y, dou v by dou y. So this 2yz, 2yz. And for dou v by dou z, dou v by dou z. So y square is constant value, so only y square. So only y square. When you take differential with respect to z, right? Dou v by dou t. So here t is absent, that's why dou v by dou t is 0. So this is regarding the dou v by dou t. Now we know that w value, when you compare this w value, minus 2xyz minus yz square. So first of all, we take dou w by dou x because w is there. So we concentrate on dou w by dou x, then dou w by dou y, then dou w by dou z, dou w by dou t. So first of all, we take the differentiation. So dou w by dou x is equal to minus 2xyz, sorry, minus 2yz. So xyz becomes yz because x is derivative differentiate take 1. So here absent, x is absent, that's why only minus 2yz, correct? Now we move for the value for dou w by dou y. Here we can say dou w by dou y. So while defining dou w by dou y, what will happen? Dou y is present, so 2 minus 2xz minus 2xz, and for with respect to y is there, that's why y is z square is constant, so that's why I can write z square over here. Now we concentrate for dou w by dou z. So dou w by dou z. So here z is there, minus 2xy. So dou w by dou z becomes minus 2xy, minus 2xy. And we can take z, that's why 2yz, 2yz. So this is regarding the values of dou u by dou x, dou u by dou y, dou u by dou z, dou u by dou t. Similarly, we have found out for dou u by dou x, dou u by dou y, dou u by dou z, dou u by dou t. Similarly, for dou w by dou x, dou w by dou y, dou w by dou z, dou w by dou t. So this defining value, we can put the in terms of ax, ay, z. So first of all, we take the ax term. This whole term we can take on that side. So ax is here. So ax. So put the value of u here, that is x square y, dou u by dou x. What is dou u by dou x? 2xy. So you follow this line only, we will get the value of x. Okay. So first of all, put the value of a u is the x square y, dou u by dou x is 2xy, correct? Plus, so plus is same here, v value is y square z. So y square z into dou u by dou y. Dou u by dou y means here, x square. So we can put the value of x square here. Plus w is there. W means this value, minus 2xy plus yz square. We can take minus common of this side. So that's why we can write like this. And for dou u by dou z is 0. So I put the value of 0. And dou u by dou t is 0. So that's why we cannot take plus 0. Directly can take this value. So after solving or after simplification, we get the value of ax like this. And we know that value of x, y, z, x is for 2, y is 1, and z is 3. So after putting the value of x, y, and z, so ax value becomes 28 units. So this is for AX side. Similarly, we'll go for AY. So as we know that AY formula is U dou U by dou I, sorry, dou X plus V dou U by dou I plus W dou W by dou Z plus dou V by dou T. So you follow this line first. As we know that U value is X square Y, dou U by dou X, dou V by dou X 0, dou U by dou X is 0. Now V value is this value Y square Z, Y square Z, dou U by dou Y, so dou V by dou Y, that means 2YZ, so put there 2YZ. Now plus W is there, so what value W, minus 2XYZ minus YZ square, so you can take directly here, and dou V by dou Z. So dou V by dou Z means what? So here that value becomes Y square, so you can take Y square. And always remember that dou V by dou T, that that all terms will be 0. Okay, now the put the value of X, Y, Z. X is 2, Y is 1, Z is 3. So here we put the value of after simplification, and then we get the value of AY, that is minus 3 units. So this is regarding the AY. This is acceleration in a Y direction. Now for Z direction, acceleration in Z direction, that equation is we are copied from this, that is U W dou W by dou X plus V dou W by dou Y plus W dou W by dou Z plus dou W by dou T. So here AX becomes here value is 28. So similarly we can compute the value for the AZ like this. So AZ value, put this value of U X square Y dou W by dou X minus 2YZ minus 2YZ plus for V purpose Y square Z plus V Y square Z dou W by dou Y dou W by dou Y minus 2XZ minus Z square. So we can take minus, okay, here. Then next plus W. W value is minus 2XYZ minus YZ square. We can take like this. Then put the value of dou W by dou Z. What is the value of dou W by dou Z? Like this. Minus 2XY minus 2YZ. So after simplification, we get the equation like this. And after putting this value, that X is equal to 2, Y is equal to 1, and Z is equal to 3. So after putting the value of this, all the terms, we get the value of AZ, that is 123 units. So this is regarding the AX, AY, Z. Then we can take the square root of this AX square, AY square, AZ square. Then we get the value of acceleration. So now compute this. As you know that AX value is 28, AY is minus 3, and AZ is 123. So 123 is there. So first of all, we know that the acceleration vector, that is AXI plus AYZ plus AZK. So put the value of over here, that is AX 28, AY minus 3, AZ 123. Then present acceleration is A square plus AY square plus AZ square. So put the value of AX square plus AY square plus AZ square. So after putting this value, we get the value of 28 square minus 3 square is 9. 123 square is 15,129. So after taking this value, we'll get the 126.18 units. So this is regarding the resultant acceleration. So here only we have compute the AX, AYZ. And then we have put up in a resultant acceleration formula, and then we have to formalize. After this, we get the value of resultant acceleration. So this is regarding the velocity and acceleration. So here, why we written these units? Because in the formula, or can say in the equations, it is not mentioned the values of the velocity. That's why we are taking the units. So this is regarding the velocity and acceleration. So this is the formula value. Thank you.